there's this awesome holiday that we have, October 12th. So if you know me, you know I love children. And so does Jesus, by the way. So children are pretty darn special, and we love them. So I think it's really cool that we have a special day, October 12th. And it's actually a big deal. It's a big deal like Mother's Day, big deal. So think about Mother's Day and all the hype that goes around that and being like, oh, and all the special feelings you have of mothers, and then translate that to children. And that's basically what you have for Children's Day. So it's a really cool time. And what I love, I think, the most about Children's Day is seeing the people in Brazil reach out to children that are not their own. Obviously, making sure it's something special for your own kids. I don't think we have too much of a hard time getting nudged in that direction. But also, I've just found that so many people, especially around Children's Day, reach out to me and say, hey, can I help? How can I help at Living Stones make sure those kids get to celebrate too? And, you know, just people in the community, you know, the kids would be like, yeah, it was so cool this weekend. We had three different parties of like people in the neighborhood just putting on something special for the kids in their neighborhood. And I'm like, that is beautiful. That's incredible. So the history of Children's Day, if you don't know, I think in the 1800s, there was a pastor in Massachusetts who was like, we should do Children's Day. But it wasn't anything official. Actually, the first country that decided to celebrate Children's Day was Turkey. All of this is according to Wikipedia, so I hope it is true. So Turkey, I think it was like the 1920s. In the 1940s, I believe, there was like world gatherings or, you know, UN kind of stuff. That was the 50s, I believe, where they were like, you know what? We need to put together children's rights. We need to focus on making sure that we are taking care of our children, and not just in one place, but around the world. Especially, you know, after people were realizing more about the importance of raising children and getting them education, and child labor laws going into effect and all those things, it was sort of just a progression of, okay, so Children's Day was set up basically as a time to remember, hey, kids are important too. Let's make sure they're getting taken care of. So in Brazil, it's a pretty big deal. You get, it's right around an official holiday. So you actually get off for the official holiday, but everybody calls it, you get off for Children's Day. Teacher's Day is like October 15th. So it's like a whole week of celebration. We have like Olympics and games and all kinds of stuff at schools. It's a really big deal. So Children's Day, I wish we celebrated more in the U.S. Just because it's such a beautiful thing. I do think we love and appreciate our kids, but just like moms, it's pretty cool to have a day just for them. So that's a quick review of Children's Day for Americans who may not know.
With school not allowed to return to in-person classes in Brazil this year, anything involving children is still greatly restricted. For Children's Day this year, we worked hard to meet the families and best serve them in a safe and secure way, including passing out food baskets, having a drive-through style setups, and even giving out and decorating masks. We were sad that we were not able to celebrate at all in Guadalajara, the hardest hit by COVID. We know the kids are going through a lot and ask for your continued prayers and support.